In this video, let's talk about a pinched nerve in your hip. Hi, welcome back. This is Elbu, your exercise physiologist, here to help you better understand your body so that you can improve in your health, fitness, and performance. Now, don't forget to subscribe to my video. Don't forget to hit the bell button. This way, YouTube will notify you when I post a new video. Right? In this video, we talk about hip. In the last video, we talk about the hip impingement. This video, we talk about the nerves. Both of them can come together sometimes. And when we look at the nerve, you want to think of it as a very complicated system. The reason why I say it's complicated because so far no one has been able to tell exactly why nerves are doing things they are doing. And everybody's symptoms is slightly different when it comes to nerve. And something that you have to understand is also that if you're feeling symptoms that's or signals that's picking up by your nerve, it just means that the nerve is actually doing its job. And by that saying, your nerve, for example, let's do this. If I were to flick my finger on another finger, right, this way, you would feel something. I actually did, right? This is a signal that is picked up by your nerve and it's sent to your brain, basically telling your brain that, hey, it's painful. Similarly, when there is some form of soreness, some form of pain, some form of nervy sensation, pins and needles, ants crawling, shooting pain, these are very common symptoms when you get picked up by the nerve, right? But most of the time, people want to treat the nerve. The thing is that there's nothing wrong with the nerve. So don't try to complicate things and try to take medicine or try to, excuse me, don't try to do anything to the nerve. That's how I see it, because if there's nothing wrong and the nerve is picking up signal, we want to understand why the nerve is doing this. So how do you know when you get a pinched nerve? Basically, you will feel things running down your legs. It could be pins and needles, it could be numbness, it could be shooting pain, it could be ants crawling down, things like that. So this is basically your nerves picking up signal, signaling you that something is wrong around that area. And if we look at the nerves involved, you can then understand why you're feeling in a certain place. But at this point of time, the nervous system is quite complicated. Nobody can actually feel exactly the same symptoms. It's kind of like a mix, and this just means that the nerve is involved. That doesn't mean that the nerve has a problem. A lot of times, people want to treat the nerve because of these symptoms. But if you don't get to why the nerve is actually picking up all this signal, then you will always be just treating the symptom and not the root cause of the problem. And you want to get to that, you have to actually go through some examination. All this kind of nervy sensation, I know it can be irritating. I know it can be hindering your daily life. And that's why if you are already feeling all this, you need to see a professional, right? So let's go to your 3D model. Let's take a look over there and then we'll come back here. So over here, let's take a look at the nerves that's involved around your hip. And basically you can see that there are actually nerves running down your leg, whether it's the front or whether it's the back, right? So it really depends on which nerve and what nerve we're talking about over here. So let's remove the muscles first. You can then see why you're having certain nervy sensation or things that can be caused by the nerve, right? So if we purely just look at the bone and the nerve system, you will realize that one nerve
that's actually running from the front is basically over here. Right? This guy originate from the spine. Before that, you realize that all nerve actually comes back. Wait, what's going on? Right. All nerve originate from your spine. Whether it's for the upper body or whether it's for the lower half of the body, and it connects all the way up to your brain. And this area, let me just remove the bone. So you will see that without the bone, this is what the nervous system looks like. They are just spread around your body, picking up signals and getting your body to do the job. Right? So, the nerve basically originates from your brain. And it's just collecting information and sending information down to different parts of your body. Right, so let's get the bones back and let's go back down to your hip and let's look at this muscle, this nerve again. So you realize that this nerve basically runs from your spine and basically runs down the front of your hip, and it goes down to the front of your thigh. Okay, so this is where it is. Now part of it basically got branched out and it actually goes on to the side, and then kind of really beside the knee, right? And then goes down. Right? Most of the nerve you probably never heard of. They have names as well. The most common ones, everybody will talk about the sciatic nerve. And yes, the sciatic nerve is basically over here. Right? Similarly, it actually goes up to your spine and then up to your brain. So you can think of them like a bundle of wires running down your body, and they're basically picking and sending up signal. So along the way, they may get interrupted because of different things happening. And as for the sciatic nerve, you can see that it actually runs down, and once you reach a different area, it's called a different nerve. The sciatic nerve is basically from the back of the buttock to the back of your knee. Okay, so you see, once I click this, this belongs to another nerve. So the entire thing running down, it's not the sciatic nerve, but because of how it's connected to different nerves, over here you have your tibial nerve, right? And then this just different nerves running down the leg. And that's why people feel shooting pain or numbness that runs down the back of your leg. And if you were to backtrack, of course, you will come back to your sciatic nerve, and then beyond your sciatic nerve, it goes back to your spine and then up to your brain. So this is how the nerve gets involved. But you realize that if the nerve is by itself, it doesn't quite get into trouble. If you really have to get the nerve injured, the trauma should be quite huge and quite big. You have to get into a very big accident, almost like getting your leg chopped off or getting cut, before the nerve can get into trouble. Right? So that's what's happening to your nerve over here. And let's bring in the muscle. And a lot of times, they are basically neglected because pinched nerve happens when it's pinched by the muscle. And in its relaxed and not so tight, or some people call it inflamed, it shouldn't be pinching on nerve where the nerve runs, right? So along this nerve in front, you will see that it has to go past different parts of your body before it runs down. And this is one junction that most people get themselves into trouble. And if we look further down, you realize that there are also different parts of the muscle that can be compressing on the nerve, right? And this is pinched nerve for you. Similarly to the back, right? You see this nerve running down, but it has to go through so many different layers of muscle that can be pressing on the nerve. So one main junction for this sciatic nerve is basically this area over here, because this group of muscles can be also squeezing on the nerve. And if we were to look further up, as mentioned earlier on, this nerve runs this way, right? And when you go down, there's a tendency of tight muscles that can be pressing on the nerve that can also be causing pins and needles running down the leg, right? So don't just look at I know you may be searching for pinched nerve on the hip, but these are some of the things that can also happen in different parts of your body. Okay, so if you never get your hip, or rather you never get your nerve into problem, most of the time it's not going to be the nerve system's problem. All right, so this is what I want to show you over here.
Right, so there you go. That's basically the nerves that's running down your leg, basically the front and at the back of your hip. And depending on where you feel, depending on where you're picking up the signal, it tells us a lot why you're feeling certain sensation around those areas. Right? So things that can actually contribute to this could be your muscle, because you look at the 3D model, you already understand why the nerve can get involved over there. And that's basically a lot of times why people are getting all this sensation. Well, because I'm the muscle guy, I will look at the muscle in the first place. And it's a lot easier to just go to the root of the problem, because I know this is one of those causes. Right, so if you haven't looked at one of my videos that can help you with relieving of the hip flexors, you can actually take a look over there. So that's it. This is all I have for you in this video. So if you like this, don't forget to click on the like. And if you haven't subscribed to my video, the button as well, and also the bell button, because this way YouTube will notify you when I post a new video. And as for the like button, YouTube will notify people when they're looking for similar videos. Right? So this is all I have for you. Please take care, and I will see you in my next video.